Well, students, in the previous lecture we had derived an expression for Compton shift. So this formula we had derived. Now we are going to draw few inferences from this expression for Compton shift. The first thing is that what is greater, lambda dash is greater or lambda is greater? Wavelength of modified component or wavelength of unmodified component is greater? Now, experimentally, we know that lambda dash is greater than lambda. But based on this formula also, can we show the same thing that lambda dash is greater than lambda? Let's see that. Now, the right hand side of this formula is this part here, h upon m0c 1 minus cos theta. Now, this part here, because h, m0c are positive constants, 1 minus cos theta is always a positive number for whatever value of theta you put. 1 minus cos theta will always be positive, greater than 0. At the most, it will be 0. When theta is 0. So when theta is 0, cos of 0 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. Any other value of theta you may put, you will always get the answer of this term in the bracket to be positive. So what we conclude is that the right hand side of this expression is always a positive number. So it implies therefore that lambda dash minus lambda is greater than or at the most equal to 0, which in turn implies that lambda dash is greater than or at the most equal to lambda. So this is the first inference. The wavelength of the modified component lambda dash is always greater than the wavelength of the unmodified component lambda. The second inference we draw from based on this Compton shift formula is that what does Compton shift depend upon? Compton shift lambda dash minus lambda, if you see on the right hand side, the only variable in the, on the right hand side over here is the scattering angle theta. There's nothing else there. So what we conclude is that the Compton shift only depends on the scattering angle theta, and is independent of the wavelength lambda. In the right hand side of this formula here, there's nowhere lambda coming. So whatever may be the incident radiation wavelength, the value of Compton shift is always going to be the same for a particular angle theta. Okay, so Compton shift only depends on the scattering angle theta and is independent of the wavelength of the incident radiation. So whether x-rays are used or gamma rays are used, the value of Compton shift for a particular angle theta will be the same. The third are different cases which we are going to study by putting different values of theta here. Okay, some standard values of angle theta we are going to put, and three such cases we are going to study. The first case, when theta equal to 0. Okay, now when theta equal to 0, cos of 0 is 1. So the bracket term 1 minus 1 will become 0. So the entire right hand side will become 0. So which in turn implies that lambda dash minus lambda is equal to 0, which in turn implies that lambda dash is equal to lambda. So for 0 degrees, that is the in the direction of the incident radiation. So what is this direction of incident radiation? So when, here, what is the meaning of theta equal to 0? So theta equal to 0 is in this direction. So you place a detector over here. So in this direction, what is the observation? So when theta equal to 0, we get lambda dash is equal to lambda. And if you remember the results observed by Compton in the experiment, at theta equal to 0, only one peak was obtained. Only the lambda peak was obtained. And that is as per this conclusion which we just inferred from this formula. So at theta equal to 0, we expect only one peak. Why? Because lambda dash is equal to lambda. Both the peaks overlap each other and only one peak is observed. The next case is for theta equal to 90 degrees. So now in this formula, if you put theta equal to 90, cos of 90 is 1. Sorry, cos of 90 is 0. So the bracket term will be just 1. And the value of lambda dash minus lambda will be just this h upon m0c. So when theta equal to 90 degrees, the Compton shift value lambda dash minus lambda is just h upon m0c, which is a purely a constant, because all these values here are constant. H is the Planck's constant, m0 is the mass of the electron, c is the velocity of light. So all these are constant values. So this term is called as the Compton wavelength. It's a constant. H upon m0c is a constant and it's called as a Compton wavelength lambda c. So for theta equal to 90 degrees, the Compton shift attains a constant value called as the Compton wavelength lambda c, and its value can be calculated by putting the values of h, m0 and c. H is 6.63 10 raised to power minus 34. M0 is 9.1 10 raised to power minus 31. That's the mass of the electron. And c is 3 into 10 raised to 8, that's the velocity of light. So putting these three values, you can see with your calculator, you will get this answer, which is 2.42 into 10 raised to the power minus 12 meters, which I can convert and write as 0.0242 Armstrong units. So this is the value of Compton wavelength, lambda c. The third case is when theta equal to 180 degrees. Now in this formula for Compton shift, if we put theta equal to 180, cos of 180 is minus 1. So the term in the bracket will become 1 minus minus 1. So it will become 2. And the value of Compton shift will then become 2 into h upon m0c. So that we can write it as in this way. So when theta equal to 180, Compton shift lambda dash minus lambda is 2 times h upon m0c, which is 2 times lambda c. Why? Because this constant term over here, we had written it down as the Compton wavelength lambda c. So it is 2 times lambda c. So double of this value. So which is 0.0484. Now what is the significance of this? This value 0.0484 Armstrong units is the maximum possible value of Compton shift. Why? Because whatever may the value of theta you may put, you will never get the answer more than 2 into h upon m0c. So when theta equal to 180, the lambda less minus lambda Compton shift attains its maximum possible value, which is 2 times h upon m0c. So this value 0.0484, which is 2 h upon m0c, is the maximum possible value of Compton shift irrespective of the wavelength. So you can see there's in this thing, there's no lambda coming here. So whatever may be the value of incident radiation, the value of Compton shift is always, the maximum value is always going to be the same. Okay, it will be 0.0484 Armstrong units. So these are the few inferences based on this Compton shift formula we have noted down. Thank you.